एवरीवन, वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड। माय नेम इज आशिम दत्ता एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट ब्लूटूथ वायरलेस टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रेनर किट एंड इट्स ऑर्डर कोड इज 21225200.4। सो इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स बॉडी स्ट्रक्चर एंड वर्किंग। सो दिस इज द वायरलेस टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रेनर एंड हियर वी आर हैविंग ब्लूटूथ मॉड्यूल। सो दिस इज द ब्लूटूथ वायरलेस टेक्नोलॉजी ट्रेनर। So firstly we will see the panel. So these are the four screens we are having on the panel. Then this is the main motherboard of all those four panels. Then these are the four Bluetooth modules that are mounted on the motherboard of these panels. Then here are three switches which are given for operating. Then there are 5-pin male connector through which we will connect this kit to the PC. Then there are again switches present through which we will control the operations on this kit, and we will perform experiment by using all these switches. So this is the panel structure.
Now we are going to perform an experiment on this kit, that is to study Bluetooth protocol in embedded application. So firstly we have to insert Bluetooth module into J25, J26 and J27, that is located on the four nodes of the motherboard. Then we have to keep SS4, SS6 in down position and SS5 in up position. These are the switches that are present on the motherboard of all the four nodes. Then we have to make power on. So after switching on the kit, we will see this message on the display. So this is the message showing select WL protocol Bluetooth, then S2 for increment, S3 for decrement, S4 for save and next. So S2, S3 and S4 are the switches that are present on the motherboard. So through these switches we will control the panel. So in this experiment we have to make 3 nodes out of 4 nodes as slave and the remaining 1 node as master. So I am going to treat this panel as slave. So I have to code this as slave and then I have to code the other 2 nodes as slave. Then I am going to code the remaining 1 node as master. So the master will control all the 3 slaves. So let's see how we can make this panel as slave. So for that, firstly we have to press S4, that is save and next, as this protocol is selecting Bluetooth. So I am pressing S4, then again I have to press S4. These are the default ranges that are showing on the display, so we don't need to make changes of these default range. So we will press S4. Now we will again press S4, and now you can see on the display this is showing BT module presence detected. So the Bluetooth module gets detected. Now we will press S4 and we have to give this node as name B. So you can give name by using S2 and S3 switches. By using these S2 and S3 switches you can give any name to these panels. You just need to give identical names to all the four panels. So here I am giving this panel as name B. Then we will press S5 and now we have to select this panel as slave. So we will again press S2 or S3, and now you can see that on the screen there is a message showing select Dave connection mode slave. So we have to select this as slave. So we will press S4, that is save and next. So you can see that on the display it is showing awaits connection. This means this panel is coded as slave and it is waiting for the master to detect it, and then we will send message from master, and then this slave will show message that is sent from the master. Now we will do the same process with the other two nodes. So again on the screen you can see that this is the other node of this kit. So we have to again coded it as slave. So we will press S4, then again S4, then again S4. Then here on the screen you can see that this display shows message as BT module presence detected. So our Bluetooth module gets detected. So we will press S4. Now we have to again give it name. So we will use S2 and S3 switches to give this a name. So I am giving it as C. And now I will save this name. So for that I will press S5. Now I have to select it as master or slave. So I am coding this as slave. So I will use S2 and S3 switch, and now you can see that on the screen there is a message shows select Dave connection mode slave. So I will press S4. So on the display you can see that this node displays as awaits connection. So again this node is also ready as slave and it is waiting for the master connection. Now we will do the same process with the third node of this kit. So we will again press S4, then we will again press S4, then we will again press S4. And now you can see that on the display this message shows BT module presence detected. So we will press S4, and now we will give this name as D by using S2 and S3 switches. Then we will press S5 for save and next. Then we will select this as master or slave. So we have to select it as slave. So for that we will use S2 and S3 switches. Now we will press S4. And on the screen you can see that message displays as awaits connection. So this node is also coded as slave. Now we are going to make this panel as master. So we have made all the other three nodes as slave, and now this is the one remaining node and we have to make this as master. So for that we will press S4 first, then we will press S4, then we have to give this name. So we will use S2 and S3 switches. So I am giving this name as A. Then we will press S5. Then we will select it as master. So we will press S4. Then we have to select multiple because we are doing it for multiple connection. So you can change the single and multiple by using S2 and S3. Then we will press S4. And then you can see that on the display it is scanning. So the master is now scanning all the nearby Bluetooth modules. So it will scan for 15 to 16 seconds. And now you can see that on the display it has detected 3 Bluetooth modules. Now we will press S4 for next. And now you can see that on the BT select there it has selected by default D. So we will press S2 and you can see on the connection count there is an increment. And now we will press S4. So we have selected multi-mode, so only one module is selected now. So we will again go to return, so we will press S2, then we will again press S2, and here you can see that the connection count again increases, and now we will press S4. So now you can see that on the panel there is a display which shows select slave D. So we will select slave D, then we will press S2. So we have selected the D node. So now we can send any of the messages through this master slave to the D slave. So let press S7 switch. So you can change the name by pressing S2 and S3 switches. So I am changing this name as Tesca. So I am pressing S2 switches. So here you can see that I have changed this as T. Now for moving forward we need to press S4, then we will again change this as E. So we will use S2 and S3 switches for that. Now we will again need to move forward, so we will press S4 switch, and now we will again change this as C, and now we have to again move forward, then we will press this S3 switch. And now we will again move forward by pressing S4 switch. Now we will change this as blank. And we have to make this as blank also. So now you can see that on the display there is showing message 1 Tesca and S5 save and next. So I will press S5 for save. So this is the message that is showing on the master node. So we will send this message as slave message. So we will send this message to one of the slave, and we have selected D slave. So this message will go to the D slave. So for that we will press S5 for sending the message. So we will press S5. So after pressing S5 you can see that the message status is showing on the display, and it shows the message was sent. So we have to go to the D slave. So here on the D slave you can see that there is a message received. So we have to press S2 for show received message, and now again we have to press S2 to see the received message, and you can see that the message that was displayed on the screen is same as that of the master message. So you can see that the name has changed, which is as Tesca Education Tools, then L3, L4 are the lights that are in off status. Then there is a frequency that is 43, then there is S4 for return. So this is the same message as master. So we can select the other slave also. So I am returning to the master node. Now we will press S2 and we will now press S3 to select other slave. So Here we will press S3 for next. So now we will select B slave. So we will press S2. So you can again change the message and you can again save this message and you can send this message to the other three slaves by selecting the slaves. So now I have selected the other slave and now I will send the same message to that slave. You can change the message according to your need. And you can change the frequency L3, L4 and this Tesca and education tools by pressing the switches. So now I will press S5 for sending this message to the slave. So now the message has sent. So on the display you can see that the message status is message sent. So this message is sent to the slave. So we will move to the B slave to see this message. So here on the slave you can see that the display shows message status, message received. So now we will press S2 to show received message. So I am pressing S2 switch and now we again need to press S2 switch to see the received message. So we will press S2 and now here you can see that on the display the message is same as the master. That is Tesca Education Tools L3, L4 off and frequency 43 and S4 return. So this is the same message as the master. So that is how you can send messages from master to all the three slaves. So that is how this experiment is performed.
So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.